All right, welcome back. Just over 10 hours remaining, and if you are still with us and you're going to stay up all night, then you are close to being over that big.
Over that big.
Hell.
Hello?
That's not a good word to let off on.
Hello, yes, this is Deku.
Oh, this is the fact that probably because, for some reason, other push-to-talk buttons I use actually do keep the thing open up until you hit the button and there's no latency. And
whoa,
I mean,
there's something
sort of
happening
like
in the race. Isaac Price set the fastest lap.
He's out with a couple amateur cars that he's between that he'll have to negotiate in the track.
How do you set a fast lap, a 13.6 at 5 a.m. in the morning when you've already been driving for like 8 hours?
Magic.
That is pretty sick.
Car 05 drive through for the avoidable incident with car 05 that is now finally being applied.
Sorry, last lap motorsports Matt Kingsbury. Part 9 seems to be his nemesis today.
KY3 seems to be his nemesis.
Matt Kingsbury and the Turn of Doom.
Tracker gaps are revealing no real close battles. No, that's all.
You still
trouble,
got
so.
The Infinity Esports and LLM.
Yeah, well, there are a few cars that are sort of close to each other, but many of the cars are on different. Pit stop strategy, or not strategy, but rotation. So there's always one car that's a lot heavier than the other one. So it's not really a fair fight like that. Let's see who has made the least pit stops so far in the race. Out of everyone running, that is. As far as I can see, this Infinity Esports Pro car has done 10 stops and they're currently running at 9. And then we also have Team 6A Fondo running in 25th overall and something in their class. They also have also done 10 stops.
Ooh, and Matt Kingsbury is in gravel in the booty chicane. Getting out slowly now, though. Man must have bought poles while negotiating his way out of the gravel trap there. But seemingly no more damage to the Last Lap Motorsports amateur car.
Yep, and Tommy Oscar into the pit, so Joe Latriello can continue.
And currently there are actually only four teams on the lead lap, but I believe Isaac Price is supposed to come into the pits pretty soon. Oh, there's Korov in turn 9.
Yep, Pajendak off it. Turn 9, just a bit of a loop around. He's back. By the way, some other administrative cleanup. The incident earlier in the race between NX Racing, Isaac Price, and Ixion Sims Ford's Nicky Jakovich that was caught right live on stream just after the first restart has resulted in a warning to Isaac Price and car 13 for avoidable contact, avoidable incident, going for the gap that kind of wasn't there, and also the appealed incident between cars 07 of Ixion Simsports and Last Lap Motorsports Amateur Car 57 has resulted in a reducal of the penalty to Car 57 from a drive-through for shortcutting the course to a warning, and taking into account that they were kind of squeeze-played onto the grasscrete and over the sleeping police.
Yeah, Yeah, well, that's for sure now when you have Isaac and Nikki on the track. There's most likely gonna be something happening. Those two doesn't seem to be able to hold their hands off each other at any time.
James Peace in the pit lane for Team Byron. Let me see them. Damn nation. Well ahead of the Terra Mine Factory car, that'll be close between Sven Charisma. Peace already in turn one, and Charisma just coming towards turn one now. So, excuse me. Peace. Back. Samsa Yerventu in for Jonas Kost. Isaac Boxes. Robin Friskaps in the server to take. Hours 52 minutes, just under that remaining in the race. Seems like such a short time remaining.
Yeah, exactly. 9 hours. You can't barely do any racing.
Speaking of the number 9, there's car 9 of Core Racing Pro number 2, Timo Suninen, behind the wheel. Haven't seen much of them. Core Racing actually kind of being fairly quiet. It's one of those teams that's been around LFS for yonks, and they're just kind of quietly plugging away. Actually, Core has gotten to be a fairly large team in numbers, fielding two cars.
Yeah, I have to say they have been sort of quiet during the whole championship. If you compare to how they were running in the front in GT2 World Series, for example, if you can compare to now, they've been quite quiet.
And Alan Maris from the amateur class lead pitting.
For anyone watching still from the east coast of the United States, welcome to February 3rd. Just after midnight here on the east coast, it's make it 11 a.m. Central Time, 9 p.m. if anyone out in California is what. So, the rest of the world about to make the one trip around the so it's I'm going to be getting pretty close in the next few hours to sunrise over in Eastern Europe, and we'll start getting the some of the continental Europeans back. It's 11 p.m. Central, excuse me. Clocks. There's some... Clocks, how do they...
You Americans must always make it so hard. Why not use the same clock?
This
same
is why I usually use 24 hour time, so I don't have to differentiate.
You always have to be so special.
If you think about the AM-PM thing, it's completely insane, because PM, which is Latin for post-day meridian, after midday, and ante meridian, which is before midday, so effectively 12 p.m. and 12 a.m. are both a notation for the midnight. And hence there is no noon at all.
If you look at some grammar style books and manuals and everything here, it does say that it's stupid to use 12 a.m. and p.m. because there is no such thing. It's technically either noon, since they are on the meridian. Dominic Engel, everyone's favorite German LFS racer right now, who designed the wonderful skin kits that we use and some other things. Some big help to GT1 World Series with deciding who's a professional, who's an amateur. Just stuck behind Benjamin Kalicki of Team Virus. Doing quite a lot of stints overnight, but I do believe once the morning comes, he will be done and we'll have everyone else back in the car. By the way,
I think you missed a couple of N's in my name.
Well, that's what you get for having a complex name. Anyway.
We have a battle.
Speaking of language things and differences,
P6
you got recently
Ixion
certified
Conquest.
Ixion Conquest battle.
Conquest is already getting passed in turn 9. Yeah, he passed on the inside already.
An actual battle on track, wow!
Yes. Well, that was a fast one though, one corner. Already pulled up quite a gap.
But, I was saying...
Oh, sorry about that. An amateur car of Infinity Esports. They're having a moment in the chicane. Do go on, yeah.
As I was mentioning, you recently got certified as able to speak the English language at an advanced level. If I'm not much mistaken.
No, you're not much mistaken. I got a certificate that I can speak English, which anyone watching the stream right now, you might find that a bit odd. But yes, I do have a certificate stating that I speak English.
Where do you buy those?
At the university.
My friend will print you a couple of certificates. They're 50 euros a piece.
That's way too expensive. I can print myself.
Not going to look official. But then again, neither does mine.
I do have a special guest.
A special friend?
No, I'm fine. But Jonas Koskinen, fresh out of the Vortex car. Jonas, how has Vortex's race been going?
Bad. Nothing else. Bad.
Said in a typical Finnish.
Well, we lost like 2 laps in the first hour, and we made a nice comeback from 24th to like, we are like 9th at the moment, so it doesn't, it really, nah, never mind, I'm so fucking sleepy, so.
Apologies for the facilities, you are in fact in 10th position if we're completely honest.
Yeah, I'll be, we'll be 9th in like 10 minutes or something. Below the takeoff,
maybe. We are watching.
You'll
front
see.
End of Samsa's car, the Vortex car.
Seems like that car has been into a wall.
Damage, but not real damage. I suppose there is a psychological effect. Do you think?
Yes, of course. Everyone wants to drive a nice racing car.
And also taking into account, it is at the moment 7:20 a.m. in Finland. Fatigue definitely creeping in at this hour.
Absolutely. So Jonas, are you getting back into the car anymore for the race, or are you?
Yeah, I'll go to sleep for 2 or 3 hours, and then I'll come back and finish the race. I think. I don't know. I'll do like 2 or 3 stints after I've got a nice little nap.
Where are you aiming to finish at the end of the race?
Top 3. It's going to be easy. We have 7.
Yes, that's good. It's always good to have a proper goal. It's not bad. A few laps behind, I guess, but it's still doable.
Yeah, it's okay. We'll catch everything in the last hour.
How hard has it been to drive during the night here?
Yeah, well, I've been up for 26 hours now, and it hasn't been easy.
Yeah, looking at the tracker, you've done 40% of your team's laps so far in the race, so you've been quite a while in the car, so I can understand how tired you are.
Mm-hmm.
Like Samsa is doing a pretty good job catching up with the Infiniti Esports car. Took almost a full second on the Infiniti car last lap, so seems like he will be right on his tail pretty soon.
Yeah, well, in fact he is.
Well, yes, true.
Right up the trumpet, and possibly. So, how eager is Santa to make a passing maneuver? Or
I think that was directed to you, Jonas.
Well, I don't know.
No,
crashing mad. Yeah.
Right.
Never mind. I don't know. He's shitting this car anyway, so too much FXR for him.
Yeah, Samsa is known to be one of the best FXR drivers around. So it's quite weird to see him. He's something else than the bus, but he seems to be doing a really good job anyway. How hard was it to convince him to get to drive another car than the FXR? Because I know he was intended to drive the FXR at first. He was looking for teammates for that car, but I guess he didn't find any. So how hard was it for him to adapt to the XRR?
It's quite close now, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
And diving up the inside.
It took 2 weeks of hard training and proper diet and stuff.
And would you care to shed some light on the diet? I'm at least eager to know how does a sim racer prepare diet-wise.
Cookies.
Of course. Anything else?
Pizza and stuff.
Nico's
and
cookies.
Lots of AS.
I think
a proper sim racer.
We've just had Christian Kistner of Core Racing Pro number 1 overtake Joe Letteriello. So Joe kind of going a little bit back.
I'm not quite sure when this has happened, but it seems like the stick breathing program actually has taken the lead in the amateur class. Although looking at the tracker, it seems like Helen did pit stop about 12 minutes ago, so I might explain that. Separated by, well, according to the tracker, one lap, but that's probably not correct.
In fact, the Hellenics, they pitted at exactly the same time as Vortex, in fact.
There's something interesting, though, looking at the amateur class as well, is that Hellenics still has the fastest lap in that class. But what is the easiest, slowest car on this track?
I think you are in fact wrong, since there is at least boss that have gone under 14.
Well, not that I can see.
This best lap for Team Rock Racing. Oh wait, that's a pro car.
That's
isn't
a pro car, yeah.
That's a. I stand corrected. Yeah. What was the other one? Oh, that was a 2:15 lap. Yeah. Back to T's.
But then at the same time, you have to remember that the further into the race you go, the more used the engine is, and I bet that most of the teams out there are right. At the moment does have some sort of engine damage, so I doubt that we're not gonna see the same bad times towards the end of the race as at the start, of course. So looking good to get the fastest lap in the slow car at the moment for Hellenic, and they're separated by 24 seconds behind the leader Stig Breeding at the moment, who's been out and running for just over the hour now. So we'll probably see them heading off to the pits pretty soon, which will give Hellenic back the lead in amateur.
So, we have another gift in our presence. Jonas has left us to get a couple hours of Kip. An old name that some might remember here in Live for Speed from back in, I don't know, say the Simturin Car Cup days. Dustin Dawes, who once some may remember him from rolling quite a bit. What's going on, Dustin?
Whoa, right. Wrong shift button. Yes, I am kind of infamous for my ability to roll a car once or twice. Thank you for the warm welcome.
Right, ability to roll a car, is that how you roll then?
That's pretty much my strategy. It's really team orders. Our teammates get a little bit behind. I throw a yellow flag by rolling. That's all strategy. It is kind of nice to get back into LFS after a few years of being not driving at all, being more involved in the community. Being unbanned from the forums helps with that, but going, actually helping people. A recent addition that I helped Vic with was on LFS World, you can now actually upload up to batches of 20 of skins.
Incidentally, have you been involved in any endurance racing in LFS?
A few years back, there was an XRG endurance race that I'd taken part of, but outside of that, I've always wanted to, but I always feel like I'm too much of a letdown for any teammates, because I'm kind of hopelessly slow.
And Michael Booth, who, as we know, knows everything. He says IGTC with someone from CTRA, possibly.
Oh, right. Back. A few Bob's years, maybe? No, I did. IGTC with Sam Hopkinson. We did, I believe, the first two rounds before, because it was supposed to be a group effort of any UKCT guys, but him and I were the only two that ever put any time in. So we have ultimately ended up just retiring from that, because there's no way both of us could take part just by ourselves. We needed a third guy at the very least.
Have you talked with Sam H lately?
Yeah, actually, I chat with him on Facebook every now and then. I actually got our old UKCT skins, the PSDs, the other day and went and created my sort of trademarked blue versions from our default reds. But he's more into the photography scene, I believe, now. He posts actually a lot on Facebook of his pictures, and they're actually quite neat if you go take a look at them. But
Empty bit of track you're looking at is the last reported place that Gamor Toth of Infinity Esports was before his time
out.
So he's now gone. They'll have to get someone in. Krasimir Ivanov is in the server to take over from Dummy A. And Marcus Gunzelman is in to take over from that man, Christian Kistner. As Kistner heads into the pit lane now. So, Dustin, have you been watching? How much of this race have you seen so far?
I've only been watching about the last hour and a half or so. I've been actually at the arena most of the day refereeing, but I intend to. I'll probably watch more throughout the night, more near the end of it.
So you're Canadian, and since you're an arena refereeing, I presume you were refereeing hockey?
That is correct.
Oh, no, dear. Sorry to interrupt, but Piotr Goik is timing out again. As the number 11 car of the Conquest Racing Team. Oh! He's suddenly come back! That's a relief. Perhaps.
for them.
Wasn't it the last race, I believe, I don't remember exactly which commentator, but they were like, they were talking how no one had timed out after like 3 hours, and then within like 15 minutes someone had timed out.
That's usually the way it works, you know, the curse of the commentator.
Yeah, everything, people say shutout in a hockey game and magically the goalie lets a goal in. It's the usual subtle jinx.
I put Team Dragon in auto, and it takes me to a bit of a battle between Ixion SimSports Wen and Suninen, but that is due to the slightly off nature of their pit stops, but they'll be on track together for a little.
I think that's one of the fascinating parts about endurance races, is there's, because you eventually end up on drastically different laps that after even 24 hours, how cars can sometimes be within 10-15 seconds of one another actually racing from position, it's absolutely amazing.
So Suninen with his slightly more worn tires, a little faster at the end of the stint, gets around and starts to gap.
Yeah, earlier this week I was actually taking some laps around this track in the XRR. It's actually amazing how difficult it is to consistently run quick laps at this track. Especially in an XRR, the FZR and the FXR are a little bit easier, but the XRR, I don't know. It's amazing that that people are able to do consistently fast laps for a couple hours at a time.
Yeah, especially KY3.
Oh, yeah, Kyoto's just, KY3 is definitely a challenge. Never mind the Boothie chicane. The first time I encountered that, I'm like, what is this? It's just weird because you're used to that sort of chicane being nearly flat out, just as left-right, to actually have it more of a proper corner. It makes it a lot more enjoyable, but it's definitely unusual if you're not used to it.
Yeah, it's quite a variety of fast and slow corners as well, especially with the booth chicane, which is probably that and the last corner, which are the two slowest corners. Then you have the high speed, really tricky corners like turn 9, which is probably one of the hardest corners on the whole track. So it's about having a fast setup that has the grip in the low corner and slow corners, and at the same time a very balanced high speed setup as well. So it's very tricky to like you say, run those sort of consistent times lap after lap after lap when there's so many corners and such a long track.
Yeah,
all credit goes to all these drivers who were able to do this for all 24 hours.
It's absolutely amazing. Because correct me if I'm wrong, but a lap around here it's about just over 2:20 around that. Sorry?
15 even.
I think that was just echo from Timo. Go on.
So, yeah, just over 2 minute odd lap, that goes through just basically the range of gears down to second all the way up to six, just fast corners, slow corners. It's an amazingly difficult track setup as well.
Yeah, for sure, absolutely. And it's even in this race, it's really been shown how much, how equally fast most of the drivers actually are, running pretty similar times as the other teams are running as well. So it clearly shows how high the standard is in LFS nowadays, to compare it to the sort of times we used to run in MOE and IGTC a few years ago. These guys are pretty much running a lot faster average times than we did back then. So obviously, of course, the tracks never change, and the setups are always the same basis pretty much. There's only a few small tweaks that you do, and unless people are stupid in some way, driving the same combo for a couple of years, of course, makes you improve.
Oh, the national.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's people drive the same setups and same track all the time. So obviously, people are gonna get faster, and it's so hard to find something special. Of course, there's these small tweaks you can do the setup, but I think nowadays a lot comes down to the drivers themselves. Just there's not really that much you can find in the setup, so it comes down to the drivers themselves nowadays. Yeah, that just shows how good their competition is.
Yeah, because I'm not a fast driver in the slightest, but even doing moderately quick laps around here there is a lot of chances of just little mistakes costing. Especially in the first sector, the sort of weird right-left corner that leads into sort of the little straight, definitely really easy to get that, just that little bit too much oversteer and getting it wrong.
Yeah, and you also have just, like, for example, exiting out of turn 4 where you have the grass on the left side, and if you put a tire on the exit there, then you're gonna have 30 tires going up to turn 5, the right hander, just before the first split there, and it's automatically you're gonna lose a couple of tenths because you're not gonna be able to go as fast in that corner just because you have dirty tires exiting the corner prior to that. So it's just these small things as well that can cost you. So, and it's so easy to do once you're pushing into the lane.
Yeah, just a couple kilometers an hour too fast exiting, and you just clip it, and the effect of grass on the tires in LFS is a lot more apparent than in other simulations as well. Having dirty tires, you definitely feel it in LFS, where other sims it's less pronounced, almost to the point of even being not felt at all.
Hey, Dominic.
It's Hello. A Dominic Engel. Hello, Dom.
Hello, Timo.
How has your race been?
Very racy. I've just driven 4 hours, and I don't know why, but my right arm and my right leg just both want to fall off. But mess. At least I should be done with driving. Unless the world goes down.
So, anything special that happened during your stints that you might have missed? Since I think
my first stint was great, and I mean, I had never done a stint like that in practice. And it was so much faster, and I got so enthusiastic, I mucked up a second one. And then I got back in the car, I don't know, I managed to get the damage when I clipped Elton Chong just a tiny bit, and it's just ruined the rest of the whole stint, really, and the one after that, too. So, Not too great, not too bad. We're still on the track, but 7, so... could be better, but could be a lot worse too.
Yeah, you currently have Ivanov in your car, 7th place, chasing down the Ixion car. They are 40 minutes into their stint, so it might be a bit hard to catch them, but I think Ivanov can do it. He's not too far away.
I don't know, Rennie, it's I just get reminded again today why I'm not a fan of 24-hour races. At least not competing in them. Watching them is fine. I mean, sitting here talking about it, talking cooperation nonsense, no problem at all. But driving, I'm very exhausting.
Have you managed to stick to your stint schedule during the race, or have you?
Yeah, I would say so. We just, well, we don't have a real schedule. We just have people available then and then. They drive after another. So that's what we've been doing so far, and it's worked quite well. Had quite a lot of availability problems with a lot of people not having time for the race, and well, I don't know, I think originally we were meant to have like 9 or 10 drivers for this. We could have put them on both cars, but now we have 4 or 1 and the whole race. Wouldn't say we're as prepared for it as in the last 3 rounds.
Still running strong, and we have a car slow in sector 1. Who is that? Let's see.
From the stream, it appears to be a fully white car at least, so.
Well, then it's gotta be the ace car, I guess, because that has an incorrect skin or something.
Yeah, in the last few minutes, I've seen actually a decent number of cars that have gone off or slid or otherwise been off pace.
Oh yeah, yeah, there you see, there's actually LLM Amateur, and that car is very bent in many ways.
Would you even say it's foobard?
I would probably go as far as using that term. She must have
been
about
one
of those.
Can we even save that on this stream?
Yes.
I should emphasize, foobar spelled F-O-O-B-A-R.
Yes, that's much better.
But you still must have somehow gone into some one of these small soft tire walls, because his whole front end's been shifted to the right and completely crushed.
Yeah. Yeah, 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 turn one. He went to into the wall after his timeout, and that's where I picked him up on the stream. He had some heavy damage. I think what he did, he hit it and it just kind of went up on its side.
He's got a massive time, but he already is losing massive time from that.
That looks something like out of a Euro NCAP test.
Kind of.
Done a good job to keep it out of the way, plus it helps it didn't have much traffic to contend.
Yeah, I noticed there's not a lot of traffic. Everyone's done, well, a marvelous job of getting massively spread out.
Oh, it's not been that way the entire time.
I don't know, it's been that way from where I was.
I've overtaken,
I think, one car in the whole time I've driven.
Definitely a well-deserved pit stop by that car.
And, Mr. Dom, the expert on GT1 World Series skin. I do believe that car 57 is worthy of a drive-through penalty for the blanks.
Apparently so, yes.
Mm. Yes, he has a few extra characters on his name.
However, that's all the difference. But he's also got a very white skin, which seems to be a fashionable item so far. Is the ASX car fair, and he's also got an incorrect number plate along with it. And he's driving undercover, you could say.
I believe that is a drive-through worthy for the blank number plate, yes?
And the blank skin. Also, he's got both.
Well, I see the skin on the...
You see the skin on 55? It's plain white for me.
White for me as well.
I think there is sometimes a... Stream sees it.
57, I see no skin on in the stream.
72.
Also 73, yeah.
In the skin. But I see it. So what I think is happening is, you know, I have the skins down and we have a problem with Russin. Just heading off in turn 3 area. What I think happens is, they do have the correct skin name, because obviously it's finding it on my computer, because I have them downloaded, the stream computer has been downloaded, but it's not loading it right.
Oh well.
I blame Eric.
I'm not even sure he's responsible for this.
The other thing is that it was uploaded to LFS World after they'd joined the track.
I think I'm gonna blame Jack Sedgwick instead.
If that's the second time in this stream that you mentioned Jack Sedgwick.
I don't think I've mentioned him before, but then I don't remember.
I believe Oscar and, Oscar and, Steve mentioned him earlier.
I don't know. It's been too long already. I don't know, I was too ecstatic in my state going like, yay, I'm doing well! And then I ruined everything almost. Well,
Joe Littoriello trying to close in on Steam Break Program M, possibly.
Don't think that's actually a battle for position.
It is, according to a lead tracker.
But he's very late instead, I just noticed.
Well,
the stick breeding program's pretty early in this stint, so... not really a battle. Position, which appears to be fifth place. I'm not completely wrong, yes it is. Between Wen of Xion Support Pro and Genuine Racing number 10. The Mashi number 10 Genuine Racing. Even. Very interestingly how Trans is going to overtake your car, that's very shifty.
Ooh, and Ghost gone again.
Actually had a very reliable connection early on in the race. It's pretty very bad at catching them out now when the fields are so spread out. In a way, that's a good thing, because technically that means you lose less positions from it, but it doesn't make it any better, really. Garvalescu rejoins time.
How come Genuine even ended up on the 6th place? I mean, what happened? They were running pretty good in 2nd or 3rd for quite a while though. How come they're down to 6th now?
What happened is that we have Origami Suspension, which gets crippled by looking at it.
Oh, that sounds lovely.
That's what happens when you dump 2 weeks into the setup, but only 20 minutes. So yeah, we've had 2 damage repairs, which cost us quite a lot of time. That's why we ended up where we are now, very close between Wen and Krazy now, but side by side.
And there goes your cones. Go.
Scared by light cars, no matter where they are, what they do. Also, Tommy Oscar can thing afford a 06 TR XR. Surprised I haven't mixed those two up yet.
That XRR ahead of the Genuine racing car is absolutely destroyed by the looks of it.
I don't even think he's got much damage, Talkiba. Although I could probably be wrong.
It just looks actually really bad.
Yeah, it just looks really bad. It's quite okay, actually.
It'll buff out.
However, it's already had a show of adventures early on in the race. But it didn't look like that then. I think that's been collected since then. Over the last half a day or so.
Definitely reveals one of the shortcomings in LFS's damage model when a car can look like if the front is completely destroyed but have perfectly fine suspension.
But it has got perfect fine suspension, it's okay, but it's not perfectly fine.
I don't have the ability to press F10 to look. I'm watching from the stream only. Oh, and Krazy's
off! Wow.
He, how lucky did he get? No damage at all. No damage at all.
But that's dented. That's dented your new car now.
But poor skin, but a dent. No, I don't like that. Wow, what a save! Just hitting it with the right rear quarter there. No damage at all. That's for professional spinning. That's unfortunately lost position again, so he'll probably, well, have to wait for that to get that back until when pits, which, well, looking at red stars, it's not going to be too far from now. So scary to cars careering up or going off into the wall on a corner like that. Wow, can't believe that there's no damage from that.
The stream on the timer appears to have frozen.
I believe Deco made the timer, so it probably broke.
The timer on top, you mean?
Yeah, it's for about 9 hours.
It's not a rolling countdown, so it updates every now and then.
Yeah, exactly. That.
But yeah, 9 hours to go.
It updates along with the tracker updates.
So every minute or so.
Yeah, right.
Which reminds me, I'm going to increase the update time just because the database is obviously getting bigger.
And bigger?
Is it gonna crash like the Mercedes website otherwise?
No problem.
I mean, that's a good prospect for season if the website crashes when they're meant to present their car.
I suppose that's not good omen. Hopefully their cars will not be crashing that much.
Well, there are HRTs which have steering or brake failure, so I don't have them this year, so... I think they should be okay, on that at least.
Well, if they maintain the same pace as last year, or... That means they'd be starting behind
Roman Grosjean. At the end of last year, they had the pace of the team they originally were when they started out, which is Tyrrell.
And by the way, with 9 hours to go, there's now only 3 cars on the lead.
Right, since it is almost
there's a car spun, that's 72 Martinez, and he's spun in a very awkward place.
Ooh, that's a very, very blind hill to be spinning on top of.
Oh, but he's going again, without any major dramas, so...
That is that combo that we were talking about earlier, where if you get your tires dirty coming out of turn 4, you can definitely get caught out in that little sequence.
It's the first time I've seen today, though. Well, it's always the first for everything, to be honest. Can't believe Racing team are still leading and by the margin they are leading it with, which is a lot smaller than once was, but well, it's still there. Ivanov's very close to the back of the Ixion car again. 4th, 5th place. Battle for 5th place on track after 15 days of running. Wonder whether he will get his... Well, no, he's not going to get his draft because he's pitting. When it's wow, great. What a awesome run.
Ooh! What's Stelagana doing? What's he doing?
He must have had some kind of issue with his controls or something, because you don't go off like that.
Might have gone a bit too far and realizing he doesn't have enough fuel to complete another lap, maybe, or why was he reversing?
James his engine's...
It's James Peasing, he just drove him off almost.
Wow, I look away for one moment and I miss all the drama.
That's nothing and compared to what we had in the first 6 hours. This would have been a 6 hour race, it would have been the best 6 hour race I've ever seen. Which is a lie, but, well, the best 6 hour race I can remember just now.
There are a few... From the last race, there are actually quite a few pretty exciting incidents as well.
Well, Laster is the best ever spin in the entire world, with the virus car locking their rear wheels massively and almost careering into another car, and that was... I'm not saying that was awesome, but I am saying that was awesome, but that was... I don't know, it was very scary to watch.
Oh, there are a few pretty... Dennis's blown tires, his teammates' blown tires. I still remember the infamous... There's a car stationary. Oh, wait, it's a rescue car on the back straightaway of West Hill.
Oh, yeah,
that
well,
was pretty
great
amazing.
Great job, Wilco. That's probably why he didn't show up today, because he's nervous and scared that we'll insult him again.
It was kind of... I was listening, I'm like, that's just absolutely hilarious. The excitement in the voice, and then, oh, it's a rescue car.
That's what Wilco does. What he's known for, and I think that's what most people actually expect him to do. So, in a way, he's delivered what people wanted.
There's always that commentator that's really there for comedic relief. There's, I think, it's Michael or Darrell Waltrip in NASCAR just saying those comedic things to make everyone laugh. There has to be that one.
Almaraz is in the pits now, and that means he's definitely lost that hand lead. Which means I've yet again changed someone in the lead. Great! I think everyone will love this race. Shouldn't be too far from a number of pit stops from various teams now, because there's nothing anymore like a pit stop cycle, at least in my opinion.
Well, considering about 20 minutes ago we were talking about how everyone was so spread out, there's nothing like a pit stop to bring them back together.
Nah, not really. I mean, if you look at, it could be very interesting where a Stick Breeding Program Pro in 4 ends up 21 car after their pit stop. If it's anywhere near close to, Ivanov. They're gonna seemingly pit at the end of the lap, more is joined to take over.
The gap between Stick Breeding Program and Terra Mine Factory is just is about 20 seconds or so.
I'd say it's more than that, probably more like maybe even half a minute. Well, now it's gonna be way because they're currently going into the pits and almost running into the middle wall. You don't want to do that. Eventually, gotta slow down. I think they're gonna come out right behind the JNR car, which means the even fewer battles. Yeah.
excite the...
And Norm's in the car, and you and I was just passing the pit, so... Yep, another battle, that's not gonna happen. At least for now. Now we seem to have a couple of stops coming in. Valtteri Pitkin and joining for Vortex, who've had a less than fantastic race so far, and Mira Rauti joins for the currently second place car 02. It's very ironic, because I think it's not happened very often that car 2 has been in second place. According to the track, it seems to be a battle for position that's relatively close for 17th overall and 6th in the M class between the 68 of Conquest Outer and the 58 of Lyra's Outer. It's at least the closest gap between two cars right now. I have both gonna have to negotiate their way around Pitkin, and it's just kind of pits for Vortex. Not go off in the process, which would be nice. I can't believe I've actually done all this gap right now.
It's actually a pretty decent gathering of cars along the back straightaway here. I don't know what relation they are in terms of laps down and everything, but they're pretty tight together, actually.
Means the just went for the chicane?
Yeah, they're
58 and 68, that's actually a battle position, that's Conquest Sam and Gyro Sam.
Yeah,
They've both had Virus didn't have a timeout, but they lost two laps within a third of a lap earlier, so.
Wow, that's unlucky.
Yeah, it got stuck in the last corner gravel trap due to, it seemed like controls just resetting or something. And then just after getting out, in the next lap in turn 4, they got punted off and were stuck again for another 2 minutes. So they lost a lot of time from that, and they're still trying to recover from it. And a Conquest Amateur gone from them. That's already had two timeouts, if I'm not wrong. And that's for position. Sixth in Am, and a position overall, 17th.
Yeah, it sounds like there's been a decent amount of connectivity problems this race. Especially compared to the winter. It's quite more, actually.
The normal 6 hour races you don't get much, really, but 24 hour races, there's always a weak time of day when people's connections just randomly go and that's it, you're gone, and someone else has got to rejoin.
I definitely think it in some of the places where internet connections are more shared than others, where cable that's not quite up to the snuff of the actual population using it definitely would have struggles during peak hours.
And now it's not really the time, but I don't know. Usually you have lots of night timeouts. It's always a theme in MOE as well. Very happy I didn't time my horse since I did, because I really didn't know whether I would. My internet connection is unpredictable.
Well, weirdly off pace by the blue car, just sort of out of the chicane, just slowed right down.
Yeah, Vortex is right on their back bumper, but I do not know whether that is. That is absolutely not full position. Vortex is way ahead of most cars, so they just want to be passed. Very quickly, please. I doubt it's gonna happen for them though, because they're just starting to stand. Chalkler's pretty much in the middle of it, of his, so he thinks, oh, well, why should I leave room for you? You're gonna cost me time. He's not obliged to let us, this is not Formula One, and he's not driving an HRT with failed brakes and steering.
Yeah, Formula 1 is actually quite an anomaly with blue flag rules, where the cars being lapped basically have to roll over and die, for lack of a better word. Most series leave it up to the passing driver's responsibility to make it work. That said, the driver being passed shouldn't make it more difficult than it needs to be.
They did defend up there, but I don't know, it doesn't really seem like Pitkin's got too much of a base advantage in any. So I guess he's just gonna have to stick around behind him for now. it is, and if you're honest, you're not getting past, you're not getting an invitation to get past, especially if you're an LMP1 driver and the car you're trying to pass is a Ferrari. It means you're probably going to rush into it, blame the GT team, and make every GT team look like they're going to kill the factory LMP teams. Great. Dude, I took that right down in the last corner. Come on, guys.
They're just making it interesting. The fans need something to watch at this hour.
But the thing is, they're making it more confusing. Especially for... Oh, dear. Whoa, that's not gonna go well.
We've got... chaos in the making. The walnut's worst is telecon, Jesus.
Yeah, let's go free wide and turn one. Yeah, let's box each other in. Oh no, it's all gone wrong.
But it didn't. They managed to pull through without nearly a scratch.
It went wrong though, telecon, because he basically lost track position to two cars. Right, they're all battling, and I think they're all not in pole position.
Who's in front of me? I don't know. Let's race whoever's closest to me.
That's what Peugeot fought in 2011 when they were out of contention for the win and just raced the Audis and blocked them like hell. Especially Anthony Davis and Marc Genève. Marc Genève actually hit him on one of the straights, if I'm not wrong. Which obviously is a great thing to do if you're fighting someone and it's televised live across the world. I don't know, just really tried to get track position so badly because, I don't know, people think on a 7.3 kilometer track they would manage to find a place of their own, but, no.
Oh, there we go!
Oh, Telkele, that's a bit of a touchy-touchy there. Between that 22 and that 58 car.
The 22 wanted to hold his line. Instead of which, as he should, definitely just tried to squeeze the 58 from making the pass. As they barrel into turn one,
they've managed it, and somehow have still not changed position. Well, at least they're fighting each other, so that's one advantage. Oh, and the passing cannon and cones. He's just trying to get into his rescue car spot. Oh dear. A bit of the action. And meanwhile, Kalowski is just thinking, oh yeah, well, you battle, I'm gonna keep my 17th place, thank you very much. He's on a longer stint, well, he's not on a longer stint, but he's early in the stint than the 58 was, so... I doubt there's gonna be a position change too soon between those two, especially with the strategy between Virus Ham and Vortex.
Now they're starting to spread out a little bit rather than being in each other's rear bumpers, corner after corner.
Yeah, it's probably a very... Whoa, well advised thing! 55 is braking very late. Oh, and actually... Whoa! Poles are flying, tires are flying, whoa, and these flying from the gravel.
Cones everywhere! And the swap goes again.
What we've actually missed, we have already passed the 400 lap marker.
Whoa, and we switched away from a crash off there. Come to the inch of the race where the race has started to fall asleep. It's just people fight each other desperately in the need of something to do other than just driving around for the sake of it. They will literally battle each other, not for position, just to have some excitement. This is what it looks like.
At the moment, the closest gap is still the gap between Turgov and Bogolowski, but that's actually getting bigger, not smaller. All other gaps are well over 10 seconds between each of the cars, if not even minutes or laps.
That said, even after...
Oh damn, now for a second we had a battle for position, but the fact is that those cars are two laps apart. That's fantastic. it's always great when it happens. And, well, they're not just two laps apart, they're actually... in LFS they might be right behind each other, but they're actually also two positions apart. There are two more cars between them. Would have been 7 Chong and 54 of Stick Breeding Program M.
Even after 16 hours, though, to have a gap of 10 seconds is still pretty good for actual racing for position.
We had a lot of race, I mean. Well, not even a lot of racing necessarily for position, but after the safety car in the third hour, something like that, and the lack of a waiver, and we just had everyone racing everyone. Doesn't matter, lap down, lap up, lap left, lap right, doesn't matter. Just, you're in the way, I want to be in front of you, go away.
Well,
it's sorted out then.
Position stuff, especially in shorter races, matters for, person in front of me, blue flag, let's make it easier, but at this point, yeah, you shouldn't interfere with someone that's in front of you's race, but if they're going slower than you, you're all the power to you to pass them.
It's now getting, for anyone living in Germany, it's probably, becoming a bit lighter outside now at 7:29 AM. Or anyone else in the GMT1 time zone, that is.
Well,
but slowly
here.
It's, getting finished with the night, or at least the European version of the night.
Over here in Canada, we're actually 10:30 PM, just starting our evening, night time.
Oh, gonna survive, then it got up 2 hours before the race start yesterday, but it's still gonna be interesting.
Well, some of the more hardcore definitely would be up if they're going to actually be involved for the whole thing, watching it. Spending a solid 26 hours at the very least without any sleep, watching, driving, even definitely a long haul.
Yeah, it's not very easy. That's another reason I don't like 24 hour races. It's not necessarily boring, but after 12 hours, usually you get that period where things start like, could end now, you know, and then that kind of goes away towards the end of a race usually, because some strategies cross each other, they create new battles where you think, wow, how did that happen? But at this point, it's a very tough part of the race right now, 15 and a half hours in exactly at the moment.
Definitely becomes a game of mental attrition of, am I, like, just even keeping the car on the track, being in a state of mind to keep driving? But at one of the more arguably difficult track car combos in Live for Speed.
Well, yeah, usually, of course, there are more harder combos, harder cars to drive, but I thought this is already a very hard track for a 24-hour race. It's not like the usual MOE AS5, it's just straight, brake, hairpin, straight, brake, hairpin, straight, fast corner, straight, slow corner, straight, sweeping pit, lots of corners, blah blah blah. You don't really have that many straights here. Well, you do, but it's, in my opinion, for me at least, it's a harder track to concentrate, to keep concentration on.
It's a lot more tight. I believe AS5 is Aston National, if I'm not mistaken.
No, that's Grumpy.
Oh. Yeah, Aston in general is pretty open for a lot of it. There's not a lot of tight sections where, here there's a couple where you do slow down quite a lot for a group of corners, and there's not a good, other than the oval section, I suppose, a good solid straightaway, clear your head, relax, get refocused point on the track. But even the oval isn't this. Whoa! We got contact here. And a stationary car in after turn 4.
That's Chong. Was a bit of a there seemingly. get another round of pickups from Nigel Ben connecting for the number 10 genuine racing car. He's gonna take over. Well, obviously, otherwise he's not gonna just camp there and watch him drink juice or something.
Hey, camping breakfast. In the server. Definitely a better spectating position.
Yeah, it's a better place, but it's called the kitchen. Also another couple of others coming in, Virus Amateur, Kaliki, Savis Sim Sports 2, I believe, Blixis joined, and Jackie for the 54 stick breeding program, and which is obviously a great team name. Still, even our four races. So, switching the topic a bit away from this, but staying with the topic of long races, I'm very much looking forward to how many cars do not finish the 48-hour Maxi Endurance race at Navarra next month. Yeah, it's a 48-hour race at Navarra, one of the which is a track in Spain, which, well, it's not a bad track, but the prize for the winner is, I think, £400,000, which is not really a motivation to join, because a GT3 car, which you need to be, well, which is one of the cars, you need to be eligible for the race, the only car, I don't know, already costs that, so, and that does not include running costs.
God, 48-hour race, that should include a free hotel room just for competing.
But the thing is, the cars probably aren't even gonna last the distance. They're not meant to be running for this long. Unless they have unbelievably long pit stops where they exchange half the car every time.
Yeah, instead of brake changes on pit stops, engine changes.
Yeah, I think actually that's gonna have to happen, because I can't believe that, for example, the engines could hold. Well, or could withstand 48 hours of driving around Navarra. Navarra isn't a particularly high-speed, massive-power track, but it's still 48 hours.
Well, the thing also about a high-speed track is you actually get airflow moving to cool down the engine. If it is a lower-speed track, then the engine actually ends up becoming warmer than if there was a decent high-speed area.
I don't think it's that sort to me. It's Let's say it's decent medium speed track, it's just a track, I was gonna say. Well,
It's a track,
yes, with left corners and right corners and straights and a pit lane and grid and lights and some grandstands, I think. Which no one's gonna be in, because it's on the same weekend as Sebring, and everyone's gonna watch that instead, because it's much better.
Yeah, the only real spectacle drawing is that it's a 48-hour race, which 24 hours
you gotta tune every 20 minutes to see how many cars have retired.
That's what I wonder what happens if no cars are running. Do they just call it a day, go to Starbucks? That would be the worst race to watch ever if all the cars retired.
And apparently we have an unlapping maneuver approaching. 06 is passing Mirror Rowdy, so yeah, Oscar out there in the TRXR. The TRXR, so fast, and the T plus Nexus, is unlapping himself from Rowdy and has done so, coming through turn 1 now. Yeah, you saw an overtake. Not the last time I will unlap itself from God knows who, or one of the top 5-6 cars, because frankly they're probably so far ahead of cars like Oscar, who I believe is in a position on the track 10th. But then we're just gonna let him go and concentrate on their race. That's probably the only thing you can do when you drive on your own, like pretty much everyone is. We actually are very close, very close, when I say very close, relatively close, battle for 4th place, which is not really a battle, because Core Racing is very much at the end of its end, but 21 Stick Re Program Pro in 4th, and Core Racing Pro number 2 in 5th, are, well, relatively close to each other. However, I almost fear they won't get into a battle before they pit. Core, that is. Be a theme now. But, oh, a battle! Oh no, wait. Is that... Sooner than they're going through past the Kaliki Virus Amcar 58XR. Not too much time lost there, except that that's not going to gain them time either, running off in the exit of the chicane. That's one of those errors you're making when you're well, probably not that fresh anymore. Car 58, which I was just talking about, Virus Amateur, will, seemingly so, receive a one-lap stop and hold penalty for an unsafe recovery from an incident. That's a quite big penalty. Oh, one-lap penalty, to be exact. One lap and the bit that it takes to get in and out of pits. Also, if you happen to be bored by the fact that there's not too much going on right now, you can, if you wish and want to see one of the drivers who is currently racing, Kevin Lyon, number 66, Green Angus Racing 2 car, you can watch him driving live, manual clutch and 8 shifter on livestream.com/LXO. You can probably think so, oh my god, I wish I could drive an 8 shifter and make it look easy and not completely not easy. Yeah, livestream.com/LXO, watch Kevin Lloyd drive with his clutch and 8 shifter. It's not bad to watch. Certainly worth taking a look.
What are your impressions of this race so far as we approach completion, the 16th hour?
It's very long.
It's 24 hour.
Yes it is. Yes it very much is. It's,
that's a whole day.
Yeah, I know. Unless you're changing the clocks back, then it's actually not.
Yeah, the Earth's rotation does slow down marginally every...
There's a bunch of left turns, which I quite enjoy.
Hello, Totally Not Joe. What have you been up to lately? Other than trying to keep awake and stuff.
What?
What have you been up to lately?
Driving.
Ah, that sounds incredibly good.
Yep. Sitting here listening to you. Waiting for a wreck so I can be a rescue for
you. I doubt that's gonna happen. Actually, I'm lying. Will probably happen, but not when you're around. It will happen just after you.
You know, there haven't been many punctures lately.
Not lately, no, because it seems like people have either worked out how to drive with a puncture, or have worked out, oh my god, my tires don't last 50 laps, I maybe should pit before that.
Yeah, how many punctures were there at the beginning of the race? Quite a bit.
Quite a couple, yeah.
I know, over 2,000 for us. Well, there's close to 9,000 hits on that poor white tire.
No.
Are you using anyone of something here?
Our intrepid. Sorry, Cameron. You were good enough for 12 seconds of that. You see, Sunanin boxes in. Box, box, box.
He's boxing a lot there. Not very much for the pit lane. Yeah. Well, he's chosen the very last. And missed it. And no, backwards. Yes, yeah, there we go. Well, and Ty Notchy actually to be up early today. And he's seemingly he's gonna try and claw some time back in that conquest car. because early on, well, when I mean early on, I mean the first 4 hours of the race, he was rather fast. Hope he's not gonna try and do a quadruple stint again. That could be quite heavy.
We see Gerberlitz coming across the stand finish line. While we are kind of in the middle of a lull just before pit stops, I make it time again to make another brief cut in a list stream so that the file sizes are more manageable, so they are more quickly made on demand for your viewing pleasure. So stay with us. You are watching the 24 hours of Kiel Grand Prix Long, presented by New Dimension Racing on Sim Race TV.